When considering what different looks to do for Halloween, the immediate thought was the new Hunger Games movie that came out, and Effie Trinket as my subject. To start, I'm going to take some of this highlighter from a Ben Nye palette, and I'm going to use it as foundation instead to get my face nice and light colored like Effie's face is. Here, I'm just going to show you where at first I applied all of the foundation, and then I'm going to fast forward through the video when I smooth it out, because you don't want to watch me smooth out this thick formula stuff for, you know, 10 minutes. Boom, pale face, yay! So, next, I'm gonna take some e.l.f. eyelid primer and put that all over my eyelids. You guys know how this works. I chose Effie because her makeup look is so fun and so colorful, and it's really out there. Next, I'm going to take more of that Ben Nye concealer, and I'm going to put it over my eyebrows, because in this look, Effie has yellow eyebrows, and yeah, I want yellow eyebrows, so you gotta conceal those eyebrows. On to eyeshadow. Just kidding. Illuminator! This is from an NYC palette, and what it does is make the colors underneath a lot brighter than they already are. I'm gonna blend that in all over my eyeball. Now for the color. I'm gonna take this nice green color to start forming this square boxy makeup that's on her eyelids. I'm actually going to end up using three different color greens to make the one color green that she has on her eyelid. So I'm going to start with a liner brush, and I'm going to create the box rectangle that goes on her eye shape. I'm a little out of shot when I filmed this, but when I come back up you can see clearly where I put the lines. The box has been created. So now I'm going to take a flat shader brush. I'm going to use my first color green and just fill in that box. It's the same color green I used to create the box. Now right now it might feel a little odd and it might look a little strange, but remember, this is Pan Am and this is the capital. It's going to be a little strange. Next, I'm going to take that next eye color. I'm going to pat that over all over my lid. So how do you guys feel about me only ever showing one half of my eyes getting done? I always feel like it's like magic. The other eye just gets done as soon as mine gets done already. And I always do the same eye first. It's kind of weird. Alright, now I'm going to take my third and final green color. Just pat that all over the lid too. This one's a little lighter, so it's going to make it a little more reflective when I move in the light. Time for the yellow. The yellow is used to blend out the green on the sides, and it's also used in the eyebrows. So I'm going to take this fluffy brush, and I'm going to use that to blend out the sides of the green. I just take it in there and I wiggle it all over. But I have to remember that the green line still needs to remain harsh. This is the future, so the makeup is a little different. Make sure you also get that inner corner also, not just the outer one. Now that I got the yellow put in there, I'm going to take this flat brush. I'm going to use this bright yellow here, and I'm going to use that to go along the sides again just to make the yellow a little brighter and a little more noticeable. I'm trying to keep the edge clean just so that it stays tight all together. Again, using the inner corner. And then with a little darker yellow, almost gold, this is the part where we go up into the eyebrow. Remember to go a little above the eyebrow, so even if your eyebrows are dark, you still get the hint of yellow on the sides. I just went ahead and used my finger because I wanted to make sure I got enough yellow on there that it was noticeable. My hair just kind of fades into the darkness of the background. It's kind of weird. Boom. Now I'm going to take, not that periwinkle, but the blue. That blue. And I'm going to use this to line the bottom and the tops of my eyelid. Here's my liner brush again. I love Effie's look because it's very colorful. I love that she has tons of makeup on. And if I could be any character from The Hunger Games, I'd probably want to be her. Or Katniss. No, never mind. I wouldn't want to be Katniss. While I love what Katniss stands for, I don't love fighting. This blue, honestly, just brings everything together. It brings that brings the gold and the green together, and it holds it all because it's like a nice turquoisey teal blue. Remember, you're also going to go across the bottom with this. And at first, I just did a nice thin line, and then I went back and did it thicker, which I think you'll see later. My eyes may look like they're getting a real little red, but that's because sometimes the powder from the eyeshadow gets on my contact. Here you can see I went back and made it a little thicker on the line there. Not using the liner brush, but instead just a thinner shader brush. I tried to stay as true to the picture that I had as possible. So next, I'm going to take this shader brush here, which is a little softer. I'm going to take this green here. It's a little darker than the greens I was using earlier. And I'm going to use that to harshen the lines and just cut out there so that you can see where it's cut. Just like in the picture where her green is just very defined. Then I'm going to take some white eyeliner and go ahead and fill in my bottom line so you make the eyes look wider. I got some blue on my face. Whoopsie. Then I'm going to go ahead and take this lighter brown here. And it's matte, so I'm going to take this and run along the sides of my nose and up to my eyebrows to create a thinner nose looking effect. And there we go. Next, I'm going to take this lighter blush, which I decided to do, I don't know why. I kind of did the makeup in this tutorial at a random spot, so you don't have to follow me. If you like to do your blush later, go ahead. This is a little odd for me. But I just gently placed it on my cheek. I didn't put a lot on because, one, I'm going to put more powder on over top of this later. So now I'm going to take some false lashes and I'm going to put them on. And instead of having you guys watch my dreadful first time ever putting on false lashes, I decided to cut this off a little early. So I'm going to magically appear with false lashes here in a little bit after a long time. Boom. Lashes on. I don't know. I guess they looked fine. And they didn't fall off until I took them off later. So now I'm going to take this black liner, and even though I went on a shot to do this, I take this and I just line the bottom part, the top part of my eye, so that it doesn't look too fake there with the false lashes. It helps cover up the band. Here I took the blue and made sure to go back over where I had put on the false lashes. Next, I'm going to take this bright pink lipstick, and I'm going to put that on my lips just like Effie did in the picture. I already did apply mascara to my eyes. Effie's lips in this picture remind me a lot of the Red Queen in the new Alice in Wonderland by Tim Burton. The way that they're more heart-shaped and a little more pouty on the bottom, and they're not very realistic looking. I believe that Effie carries this style out with her throughout the whole movie. I started just by drawing a line to create the shape of it. And then I went ahead and took the actual lipstick and went back in and filled in the lips. I tried to be very careful not to get it outside of the lines I made. In which I go ahead and have you guys watch me put on my lipstick very carefully for a long time. But this is a delicate process. So next, what I did in order to help define it even more was I took some eye primer and used it as concealer to just make sure the edge of my lips were more pale than that middle pink part. It helped it look like that was the only part of my lips there at all. So the last thing I did was I took some Ben Nye face powder in Fair and I just put that all over my face. In order to help my lipstick stay on longer too, I also patted a little bit of the powder on the lips themselves. I wanted to get an all over good finish with the powder, just to make sure that my face looked, you know, kind of flawless. Obviously, I've got some marks on my face from scarring, but otherwise it looked pretty good. So there we have it, Effie Trinket. This is a fun look for Halloween, and may the odds be ever in your favor. Music from the Hunger Games original soundtrack.